Hello everyone. This is Abdullah Ismail from the Islamic University of Gaza. We are back today, inshallah. We will continue our class on translation of style or stylistic problems when we are talking about translation. The first problem that we have is basically the translation of formality and informality. Okay. So, formality and informality are one aspect of style. Okay, we have many other aspects, if you remember the diagram that I showed you. We have the ambiguity, the passive voice, the tone, etc., etc. Let me just put this in reading mode. Style of formality versus informality. اللغة الفصيحة مقارنة باللغة غير الفصيحة أو العامية. According to Jews, I'm not sure if this is how you pronounce it, we have five levels of formality, or five tones of formality, if you will. We have frozen formality, يعني اللغة الجامدة المتصلبة. يعني very formal language, basically. We have formal language, اللغة العادية يعني الفصيحة العادية يعني, that people that you might use with peers, for example, in a business setting or in a formal setting. We have informal language, colloquial language, and slang language. Some other classifications collapse these more elaborate classifications into two. We would have formal and frozen formal into formal language, and these three into informal language. وخلص يعني بس بتصير هيك طبعا there is no clear cut rules again يعني this is language it's always gray areas we don't have black and white here for example خلينا نديكم أمثلة and how and the context of when to use such language frozen formal language for example be seated اجلس أو عليك بالجلوس if you will this register or this tone implies a person of authority, a person in power, a person in a high position, speaking to people of lower position, of lower status, if you will. For example, maybe it's a courthouse or a courtroom, and the judge tells everybody, tells the attendants to be seated. تمام or maybe it's the boss or the manager or the president or the vice president people of higher status this tone also doesn't imply friendliness it implies maybe rudeness maybe saying telling someone be seated is basically telling them I'm in charge I control everything around here not you تمام؟ فطبعاً you can find more detailed explanations to these tones about these tones in the book. This is just يعني a quick glimpse. Formal language. This is used in also formal settings or formal setting, but it implies it's a bit of a friendly tone. It implies speaking to a peer, somebody on an equal or a close level, not somebody who is high above. Informal language, for example, have a seat. تفضل بالجلوس. طلع لاحظوا, be seated. Have a seat. طبعا, if you find be seated in a text, يعني you should understand that the speaker is somebody higher than the receiver of the speech. Formal, have a seat. تفضل بالجلوس. Informal, sit down, please. اجلس لو سمحت. Colloquial, طبعا informal يعني polite, friendly, يعني you are talking with friends, intimate language. Colloquial يعني conversational language. You're talking to everyone. Feel at home. خذ طلع. When I translated it, I didn't say خذ راحتك. I tried to give it a more colloquial style, a colloquial quality feature from the Arabic language. So I said خذ راحتك instead of خذ. You can say استريح, ارتاح, كأنك في بيتك. Stuff like that. في عنا the lowest, يعني not lowest, but يعني the lowest in the scale is slang language or vulgar language, which is considered to be rude and offensive sometimes. يعني you hear this a lot in movies when you talk to somebody in an aggressive tone. You tell them sit, and then the curse word, sit the F down, for example, or sit your A down. In Arabic, we say انتظ, اقعد, ارتزي. لا, انتظ اقعد, مش انتظ او اقعد. لا, انتظ اقعد, ارتزي, انقبر. انقبر في مكانك, انضرب في مكانك. Stuff like that. For these are equivalents. They are not translations per se. They are equivalents, stylistic equivalents to the style of the English text. تمام؟ فيعني مش تروح الترجم sit the F down إلى اجلس مثلا. No, this is, you translated it, but then you ignored the style. You are now with the classical people who believe style is irrelevant. Okay, so sit the F down. It's not اجلس. It's not تفضل بالجلوس. It's not خد راحتك. It's انقبر أو it's ارتزي أو it's انتظ. Stuff like that. Sorry, طبعا for using language. I'm just for the sake of the lecture. يعني I could use worse language, but I know that the university wouldn't agree. It's okay. طيب different contexts and effects. طبعا when you talk about the context, you will study this in sociolinguistics, hopefully with Dr. Hassan. When we talk about the context, we talk about who the speaker is, who the addressee is, what the place is, what time it is, stuff like that, what the social norms are, the code of conduct, the code of communication, the channel of communication. فكل هذه الشغلات المتعلقة بالمكان والزمان والعادات والمخاطب والمتكلم هذه كلها الكونتكست السياق يعني فلاحظ انه each of these styles would have its own independent context. اجلس او be seated would probably give you the context. حكينا انه somebody high above, somebody with a lot of power. Have a seat, probably you are in a business meeting, people are trying to be friendly. Informal sit down, maybe you are with your friends. Colloquial, you are مثلاً talking to somebody on the street. Slang or always sit the F down, and probably you are talking to your little brother. You are rebuking someone, you are fighting, you are being aggressive with someone. يعني the context, طبعاً. And each of these styles gives a particular effect. تمام؟ the reader or the listener feels something different when you say be seated and sit the F down. طيب, although the message of the statements in the example is the same, in the examples is the same, the message is the same, basically اجلس, اقعد. Each statement has different effects and hence different meaning. For example, one is so official and or impolite, يعني رسمية كتير وما فيها تهذيب. يعني you're not talking in a friendly way. You are ordering somebody. You are telling somebody to be seated. Said by a harsh person or a man of a high position, a king, a president, a judge sometimes, to strangers and ordinary people. Whereas two, Leah, have a seat, is official yet polite. It's a bit, it's friendly, used in similar context to that of one. And maybe the king or the judge wants to be friendly with the other party or the other person. So they tell them to have a seat. Or the manager calls you to his or her office and tells you to have a seat. If he or she tells you to have a seat, they are being friendly. If they tell you to be seated, they are probably mad at something bad you did. It's used in similar context to that of one. But to friends and personal acquaintances, but not to friends and personal acquaintances. Moreover, it can imply that a person is polite or being polite. طيب, number three, اللي هي إيش كانت؟ Informal, sit down, please. Is not official, it's not official, but it's more polite than one and two. Sit down, please. ليش? Why is it more polite? Because it implies that the people involved in this speech act are of equal level. But be seated and have a seat implies that the speaker is of higher position than the listener. So you need to pay attention to this in translation. This is so subtle. It's more polite than one and two because the informal use in Arabic is لو سمحت, which is between formal and colloquial. يعني, why is it more polite? Because it implies that the two people involved in the speech act are equal in status, or at least close. But four is quite friendly. اللي هي إيش كانت four? Colloquially, feel at home or make yourself at home. It's friendly, intimate, and so kind. In Arabic, خد راحتك, ارتاح, استريح, كأنك في بيتك. And in particular, reflects a colloquial tone. Five, on the other hand, is strong and rude in both languages, although in Arabic it can be said humorously to a close friend. يعني تقدر تقول لصاحبك ارتزي يا زلمة as a joke, also in English. طيب, فيعني you're being ironic, you're being humorous, you're being funny when you tell somebody, when you use vulgar language with a close friend. Otherwise, you are being aggressive. طيب, so the author here suggests this big problem of different styles and how should we deal with it? The author gives us a solution. What is the solution? His solution is to minimize the English styles to one general style in Arabic, to collapse all styles into one style in Arabic, which is MSA, Modern Standard Arabic, at least at early stages of Ulak. إذا ما كنتش خبير في الأسلوب أسلوب الكتابة وآلية الكتابة وشغلات هذه at least خلص stick to modern standard Arabic. If you are not an expert on style, if you are unsure, the reason for choosing MSA is that it is the middle ground among Arabic styles. Simple, easy, more acceptable, polite, known, popular, understandable, and available to all students and to everybody. لاحظوا بقول لك if you are unsure, at least at the early stages, stick to standard Arabic. طب, I know you are experts, guys. يعني, you shouldn't always stick to modern standard Arabic. You should expand yourself. You should branch out your rendition of different styles. Thus, back to the example above, they can all be translated. The five sentences, here, be seated, have a seat, sit down, please, feel at home, and sit the F down, can all be translated according to this approach into Ijlis, which is the message in MSA, basically the bare meaning. Remember how I talked about the bare meaning, the communicative translation, which basically gives you the meaning and leaves out a whole lot of style and hidden meaning probably. When it is difficult to imitate all of these tones in Arabic, يعني just give the message. If you can't, give the style. Although this translation ignores style, it is an acceptable solution to such a problem of formality and informality of language. طبعا. I want to ask you, and maybe you can reply on the group when you watch the lecture. Do you agree? Do you agree that this is a sufficient solution, an ample solution? Do you agree that this solution solves our problem of different style with different contexts and different effects? I don't want to say my opinion, but I want you to think about it. يعني الكاتب هنا عمل لنا قصة وقالنا هذه مختلفة عن هذه وهذه وشخص قوي وهذا شخص قد والديفرنت كونتكست والديفرنت افكتس بعديها قال لك ايش؟ stick to standard modern Arabic. طب why? Why the fuss يعني? Why all this mess and fuss and noise about different styles if we are going to minimize and collapse all English styles into MSA? Interesting, interesting topic to discuss. What do you think of this solution? We have examples in the book, page 20, 200. خلينا طب نروح على الكتاب. نشوف يعني في أشياء أنا بحطش كل إشي هنا. Because I want you to always refer back to your book. Wait a second, وين البي دي اف راح؟ No, that's not it. ليش مش هذا يجي؟ اوكي. ثاني. اوكي. طيب، you should be able to see the screen now. It's loading. طيب. Style of formality versus informality. طيب, I need to hurry up because الكهرباء بعدها قطعت. I don't want this to go. طيب. هاي حكينا عن الايش؟ عن the five levels of formality. Frozen. طيب خلينا نروح على صفحة 228. هاي شايفين في أشياء معلمة هنا. نفس الكلام في السلايدات تقريبا. Look at the examples. You can't paint watercolors without knowing how to lay a wash, though anyone can learn the knack if they are willing to go to a bit of trouble. People have their own fads about the drill, but my method seems to work as anyone's. Sorry for that. طلعت بقول لك لا يمكنك أن ترسم بالألوان المائية دون معرفتك كيف تحضر الألوان رغم أن أي واحد يستطيع طلع مش أي أحد حكى أي واحد وبالعامل sorry I keep sneezing I don't know why هو يعني sometimes you can't render all the different styles or the stylistic issues into Arabic, but at least give me a general sense that the original text was written in a particular style. كيف يعني؟ هنا ايش عمل لك حاجة لطيفة جدا؟ قال لك the informal features of the English text, the use of the second person you, the use of the contraction can't. طب احنا ما عندنا كيف بدي اترجم can't؟ كيف يعني ايش حتفرق في الترجمة cannot كلمة واحدة؟ uncontracted عن can't contracted كيف ده تفرق؟ مش هتفرق because we don't have this in Arabic. This feature does not exist in Arabic. The use of words like knack, a bit of, طلع bit, a bit, a little, or a little bit are more formal. A bit is informal. Fad is informal. The use of simple common words use words and some easy sentence structure throughout the whole text. فالفكرة في مثلا can و can't ما بقدر أترجمها ما فيش فرق في الترجمة زي ما أجي أقول لك مثلا في الأفلام بيحكوا you is here or why was you not here طب you ما بيجيش معها was you were أو you are مش you is أو I am مش I is مع أنه كتير في الروايات الأمريكية كتير فيها I is و he are يعني أخطاء هو بالعامل بحطوها to convey a style to give a message through this style I can't render this how can I translate can't as opposed to cannot or I is done it as opposed to I have done it. You can't. The short answer, you can't. You can't. There is no stylistic equivalence in Arabic to this. The solution to this is you need to give a general. After all, it is not required to have the same number of the English informal features in Arabic. يعني مش معشان هنا في أربع informal features in Arabic لازم يكون في أربعة. No, because this is impossible in a way. But to use some informal expressions here and there to sprinkle them in Arabic, if and when possible, that are suggestive of a particular style that is present in the source text. إيش يعني؟ يعني أنا ما بقدر كل خاصية informal أنقلها للعربي. وحأوديكم مثال. I can't as opposed to I cannot. كيف بدي إيش مش حيب. لا أستطيع لا أستطيع. لكن أنا بحاول في اللغة العربية مواضع تانية أغير وأعمل أشياء informal عشان أبين للقارئ إن النص الأصلي كان هو informal. زي هنا قالك بدل أي أحد أي واحد. هذه الشطارة طلع شطارة كلمة informal يعني بالعربي. إن كانوا يريدون الوقوع في مشكلة طبعا I think this translation is inaccurate. يعني I think طلع إيش معناتها. Though anyone can learn the knack if they are willing to go for a bit of a trouble. A bit of trouble يعني إنه تبذل مجهود أنت تتعلم مش توقع في مشكلة. تبذل مجهود idiom يعني حتى الكاتب غلط فيها أو يعني سهى عنها. للناس مراقهم الخاص في التمرن ولكن مراقي يبدو فعالا تماما كما هو مراق الآخرين. طيب بعد نشوف الـ informal features in Arabic. The use of the second person pronoun يمكنك معرفتك المخاطب ضمير المخاطب يعني. طبعا in English this is can be formal and informal. In Arabic it's not clear because I don't know. We don't have this classification in Arabic whether a particular pronoun is formal or informal. The use of such words زي دون معرفتك الوقوع في مشكل شطارة مراق كيف في كيف ما انتبهتش على كيف كما هو مراق وين كيف مش شيء مش كيف قصده مش كيف كيف شايفين حتى هذا على الفونولوجيكال ليفل على البرونانسيشن ليفل instead of saying كيف كيف is standard فصحى بس كيف is كله informal خلينا نقول ف when you read طلع هو بالعام حط لك ايش حط لك كسره عشان القارئ يقراها بيحسها شويه عاميه informal فبيعرف انه النص الاصلي في informal features. I love this by the way. That's a really good way of showcasing the differences and يعني the different features in Arabic and in English. That's a good book. يعني every time I teach it or every day I look at it to prepare for the lecture, I like it more and more. هاي the disregard of the connected of the وين احنا the disregard of the concord between singular اي واحد and the plural verb كانوا يريدون يعني اختلاف في الايش في العدد في الاجريمنت ان نمبر وين هذه رغم أن أي واحد يستطيع أن يتعلم هذه الشطرة إذا كانوا يريدون الوقوع في مشكل أو إذا كانوا يريدون أو إذا كانوا ينوون أو إذا كانوا بدهم مثلا راح يقول إذا كانوا بدهم يبذلوا مجهود أنا بالنسبة لي هذه الترجمة مقبولة طبعا بالنسبة لغيري حيطخنا كلنا فالفكرة إنه إيش زي بالإنجليش بيقول لك مثلا instead of keep يعني you can say you can call a singular person one person you can call them they فيعني مثلا تحكي I called him او مثلا I called someone and they told me ما احكيش he or she عشان ما اقعد الخم حالي هل هو كان ذكر ولا انثى ولا مش عارف ايش he or she وانا اذا مش عارف اقعد احكي he or she ف in informal english they use they. Even though we're talking about one person, we're using they. فهي قصده أنا. The discrepancy between the number of between أي واحد واحد قصده يريدون someone they want خلينا نقول. طيب the ignorance of the standard word order يعني في إيش في لعب في word order. The vowelless stopping at the end of words by omitting vowelization, vocalization, التشكيل يعني اللي هي زي مش بيحكوا العرب لا تقف على إيش مش كانت لا تبدأ بساكن ولا تقف على متحرك هو هنعمل العكس عشان يخرب الستاندرد فيتشر هذه. The use of singular form مراقهم instead of the plural مراقاتهم. طيب, it is not necessary to translate the English informal features into the same Arabic equivalents because it is not advisable nor possible to do so sometimes. Moreover, some of these features such as can't, زي حكيكو عنها can't or don't or didn't, contractions, مش بحكو لك في الكتابة الأكاديمية, don't contract, ما تختصر, ما تعمل, خلاص, can't بتصير cannot, don't بتصير do not. فthis is impossible to render into Arabic. فإنه you change some other stuff around it to give, to suggest that this text is informal. Rather, alternative features are used elsewhere by way of compensation. للتعويض عن هذا الفقد, مش translation is loss. طب أنا can't, I lost can't هالجيزة. Can't is important because it tells me that the speaker is informal, the setting, you're talking to a friend, the effect, the context, الشغلات هذه كلها. فإنه I lost can't. So I can go around can't, around يستطيع, or change some other stuff. بخرب في اللغة يعني شوي, بعمل لغة عامية. Ignorance of standard vocalization, اللي هو التشكيل. وهي هذه after all, you don't have to have the same number of informal features in both texts, but you have to suggest that the target text is informal as informal as the source text. طبعا هانا ايش بقول لك بديك هانا ايش اعمل لك هانا revised version easier version for students. طلع ايش easier version, the use of MSA. ليش؟ Because everybody knows it according to him. I don't agree by the way. لا يمكنك أن ترسم بالألوان المائية دون معرفتك كيف طلع شال الكسرة تحضر الألوان رغم أن أي واحد خلى واحد يستطيع أن يتعلم هذه الشطارة إذا كان يريد بذل مجهود مش وقوع في مشكلة كيف عملنا strike through أي. إذا كان يريد بذل مجهود طلع خلاها وحد العدد بطلت أي واحد إذا كانوا يريدون شوف كيف subtle stuff style is so and I love stylistic problems when it comes to translation because it's so delicate and subtle. للناس أمزجتهم الخاصة في التمرن ولكن مزاجي يبدو فعلا فعالا كما هي أمزجة الآخرين أو مزاجات الآخرين. طيب good يعني طيب هانا بيجيب لك مثال تاني يجيب لك a technical or a scientific text وبقول لك إنه scientific texts are written both in Arabic and English using standard language formal language sometimes frozen formal language فإنه you don't need to worry about these subtle stylistic problems when you translate technical texts just translate correctly and accurately and maintain the general feeling of the text. English scientific and technical texts are always formal in style to imply seriousness and conservatism and internationality. Consequently, the Arabic version should be formal without colloquial features being used so that it reflects the same function of the original. طبعا عندك مثال, you can go over it. I wanted to give you something else, maybe something to think about. And I can probably share the source with you. طبعا انا هيك خلصنا يعني I just يعني go over these paragraphs they basically restate what I have said. طيب خليني بس ارجع على الباوربوينت على السريع. هاي الباوربوينت. طيب في عندي بحث لدكتور I am one of his biggest fans probably if not the biggest fan دكتور محمود الحرثاني من جامعة الأقصى. I advise you to go and I think you can probably find his some of his papers and articles, published articles online. Read them. Fascinating guy, honestly. He wrote a paper on the translation, Jabra Ibrahim Jabra's translation of The Sound and the Fury, SF, that's SF, Sound and Fury. وقارن بين ترجمتين. ترجمة لترجمة جبرة إبراهيم جبرة وترجمة مترجم اسمه يونس أحمد يونس. That's the last name I remember. ففي عنا on the word level على مستوى الكلمة و above the word level. فشوف bowl أو عفوا bowl إبراهيم جبرة إبراهيم جبرة ترجمها لقصعة. كم واحد هنا بيحكي قصعة هالقيت؟ ما حدا. قصعة is an obsolete word, old fashioned, very archaic. زمان كانت تستخدم في probably in the Islamic era. يونس استخدم طاسة. By the way, they both know the difficulty of this particular text because this text هي شوفوا هي مثلا هي مثال من الرواية. Shut up that moaning, Luster said. I can't make them come if they ain't coming, can I? طلع حتى فيش علامات ترقيم فيش can I مفروض في علامة استفهام فيش. If you do not hush up, mammy ain't gonna have no birthday for you. That's what I tell you. They ain't no luck going be on no place where one of their own shillings name ain't never spoke. شوف ما أصعبها مع إنها عامية لهجة local vernacular dialect يعني. But probably this is the toughest challenge to a literary translator. فشوف هنا. Bowl, قصعة, طاسة. Barn, عنبر, حظيرة. Slipper, خف, شبشب. You see the difference in the style of formality and informality? Jabra Ibrahim Jabra uses classical Arabic, not even MSA. But uses pre-Islamic Arabic sometimes. Quranic Arabic. On the other hand, Yunus uses more day-to-day, everyday Arabic, more the Arabic of the common man or the common person. فبار ما حدا فينا بيحكي عنبر عن حظيرة الحيوان أو عن مزرعة الحيوان أو مزرعة الأبقار يعني. كنا بنحكي حظيرة أو حظيرة حتى بالزائي يمكن بالزائي أو بنحكي مزرعة. سليبر خف ما حدا بيحكي خف ما حدا بيحكي خف شبشب. طيب I was going to give you to show you the translations, the two translations for these two excerpts, but I think it's too advanced for you. If you are interested, please message me and I can send you or I can direct you to this particular essay or article that you can read. Read وتستزيد. Allah. But I wanted you to feel the strangeness and the peculiarity of the style here. أديك خلينا نشوف مثلاً هنا في الجملة الثانية. That's what I tell you. They ain't no luck gonna be on no place where one of their children's own chillin's name ain't never spoke. شوفوا إيش الستايل. أول شيء. That's what I tell you. تمام. فيش إيش فيها بس فينا الكونتراكشن يعني مش that is that's what I tell you. They هنا there they ain't no luck there ain't there isn't no luck طلع double negative هذا برضو أحد مش there isn't luck أو there isn't any luck there isn't any water here there isn't no water here double negative برضو هذا stylistic feature. they ain't no luck going be instead of حتى هذه بيكواش going going be هاي كوه كلفظ يعني going be أو going be فالتو راحت going to be راحت ف they ain't no luck going be on no طلع double negative كمان مرة on no place where one of they بدل one of their الملكية مش their هناك where one of they على عكس هذه they طلع they or they their هناك اللي هي T-H-E-R-E هذه T-H-E-I-R own chillens instead of children instead of children chillens كان بحكي children's وحتى شال الدي والار chillens name where place where one of they chillens where one of they own chillens name ain't برضو ain't is never قصده ain't never مش spoken اللي هي تبعت الباسيف الباست بارتيسيبل لا ain't never spoke فشوف كم لو واحد شاطر يقول لنا قديش في stylistic features stylistic peculiarities خصائص وخصوصيات أسلوبية متعلقة بهذا الأسلوب جميل جدا هذا طبعا ترجمتها هتكون إشي يعني it's almost untranslatable by the way almost صعب جدا حتى لو ترجمتها لعامية ما حدا حيرضى ينشر لك لأنه العامية أنا بالوطن العربي مش متقبلة in print culture في طباعة في ثقافة الطباعة والنشر colloquial Arabic and informal Arabic is not accepted yet hopefully إن شاء الله it will be طيب that's all next lecture إن شاء الله will be about fronting we'll talk to you soon إن شاء الله stay safe stay home bye